Hi all, this is the MakeHaven video for the large belt grinder in the metal shop. This at one point was in the wood shop, so you might see some sawdust on it. It can be used for wood, but we actually just upgraded with a more powerful motor so that it can be used in the metal shop. The idea here is this is has only a flat back versus the Kalamazoo belt grinder, which has a soft part. So this is probably used more for squaring things up or deburring larger pieces. And you just, let's say this piece, you could easily do it on the 1x42. But you know, maybe this one offers a capability that you're looking for, you want to square up bigger stock or something. Again, this grinder is same idea as a belt sander, just used for metal. It can either deburr, just removing a little bit around the edge of a piece, or remove a whole bunch of material, depending on the grip that's on it, and how aggressively you push. In terms of safety, you don't want to wear gloves, you don't want anything that could get in there, you don't want to use really thin metal that could slip in. This is a fairly big crack between the table bed and the belt, so you don't want to like have something that could easily get sucked in there. If you're using something thinner, like this could go down there, then you want to make sure you're holding it up here so you're not risking one of these situations. The one advantage of this whole belt bed can tilt, so you just would loosen this and then adjust it. I've seen that coming. I'm just going to put it back to zero, but what I'm going to do for now, all right, so I'm just going to use this combination square to make sure that I put this back to 90 degrees. So I'm just going to use my stomach to lift that. So now both the bottom and the top are flat. Let's tighten down on that. In terms of how we're actually going to use it, this has a foot pedal. This is a pretty powerful motor. So the idea is if something bad were to happen, a finger gets caught, your foot is going to come off the pedal. When you're done, just ask that you make sure this is tucked back there so someone walking by doesn't actually accidentally step on the pedal. When you're ready to use it, you can peek it out of the front. Then when you are ready to use it, you're gonna have your stock out here, move it up to the front. I'll demonstrate first just how to use it quickly, and then we'll go over how to change the belt, because that's something that you want to do. This is a little bit more involved to change the belt than on the smaller belt. You're just gonna put your step on the pedal. Raise it up. You could also grab material like this. Fire up. As with all power tools, you wanna make sure that the machine is fully spinning before you touch the material to it. So, same with the cutoff saw grinder, I mean every other tool, power tool, you want to make sure that it's fully spinning and then you touch your workpiece. If you were to be holding it against the grinder first and then turn it on, it wouldn't be happy. It just kind of seize up because it needs to get a little speed going first. So now we're going to look at taking the belt on and off. So this is an older machine, they didn't make it terribly easy for us. So first we're going to this off the top, and we're going to take a screwdriver and take this screw out of the side, or bolt, out of the side, just using a flathead. So once the belt gets dull, then you'll want to replace it. We have a few on hand. If you are cruising through a bunch of them, then you'll probably want to get your own. If you want something to remove material quickly, that would be like a 60 grit that is very rough. If you were, I'm just going to push that pedal back there so I don't accidentally step on it. If you were doing something softer, then you could just, if you wanted to say you're making a knife for the first heavy metal removal, then you would want to use like a 60 grit. And then once you're getting closer to your refined finish knife shape, then you would want to use a higher grit to remove and smooth material. So you just took this side panel off, and as a good precautionary measure, in addition to pushing the pedal underneath there, we're going to unplug the tool as well. So now it's unplugged and we can comfortably work on it without any fear of stepping on the pedal and turning it on. So there are two things that we're going to use to take the belt off. First, we're going to use the one on the back that's labeled tension, which is hard to see from here, but I'm just going to turn this, and that's lowering this top wheel. You need to whack a little bit, it's a little stiff, and then this should slide off. Now we can see what happens when the blade or the belt isn't well seated, when it's going to one side or the other. You can see these grooves that have been cut into the metal housing where it's like, because the belt has been slid one way or the other, it's literally cutting into it. So that's why it's important to make sure that when you're setting up the belt, it's centered and not cutting into the material. Here's another example where the belt literally just cut right through this thick metal shield. So that's why you want to make sure that you are doing a good job of centering it. So we took it off. You could put a new one on. This one has arrows to show you which direction it should go in. So you want to make sure it's spinning this way. It says it's 80 grit. That's about all it says. And this is a 4-inch wide by 48-inch in circumference belt if you're looking to buy new belts. I'm going to take this little string off. All right, making sure the arrows are lined up. I'm going to put the belt back on the bottom drum. And on the top, in front of the platen. Platen is this piece of metal that we push against. And then we're going to give it some tension again. So I'm just going to tighten. It doesn't need to be anything crazy, just until it feels snug. We can spin it a little bit by hand to see which way it's going. And sometimes it'll shift one way or the other. So the way we'll address that is by loosening this jam nut. So a jam nut is a nut that is squeezing on here so it can't move, because this is obviously vibrating a lot. You wouldn't want it to move on its own. So we're going to loosen the jam nut, which is this one, and then tilt one way or the other. So we'll start by turning inwards. I'll just turn it one turn, which is actually a bunch, and spin it. And we can see that it's moving over to the right, which we don't want. So we're going to then go back to the left. More. And this is actually easier to do with the machine on when it's spinning itself. So what we'll do is put the covers back on so we can safely make that adjustment. So first this piece goes on, just sits in this groove. Like that. I'm gonna put this little screw back in. Top piece. Okay, plug it back in. Okay, and now I'm just going to step on the pedal so we can see where it's sitting. This is the important piece. So it's still sitting a little bit to the top. Now it's going left. We're just going to push that in a little bit, and just by little increments, easy little increment. Right, that looks pretty good. Oh, go back that way. So it takes a little fine tuning, and now it's in the middle, so I'm just going to tighten the jam nut back down, and now it should stay right in the middle. That's the position that we want. We covered using it and tilting the bed. You want to make sure there's enough tension. If there's not enough tension, then it'll be slipping, it'll be pushing, and the belt will be stationary while the motor is still spinning. So you want to make sure there's enough tension on there. It has a good firm feeling. And then again, when you're done, just make sure to push that back so no one accidentally steps on it. Good to go. Thanks for watching.